Hey, everyone, Aaron here with a fresh new gig log because it is Saturday and that means it's time for a wedding. I'm all loaded up, ready to go. Got ceremony and reception tonight. I am testing out some new speakers. I don't know if you can see them. Let me see if I can show them to you. Nah, you can't f***ing see them. They're back there somewhere. I'll show you when we get there, but I got the RCF J8 mixes. I did do an unboxing of them and I'm gonna do a review, but tonight is the first night I'm taking them out. I probably don't need these. I've got about an 80 person wedding tonight and the EV30Ms would have been perfect, but I'm like a little kid. When I get a new toy, I must try it out. No up lights, no photo booth, nothing like that. Pretty simple. 4:30 to 11 is the last song. All right, here we go. Okay, here I am, I'm at the venue. Load in is a little bit tougher. When you go downtown, there's no parking lot, which I hate. That's the one thing I love about barn weddings, just no parking problems. So I'm gonna start setting up and I'll give you a tour of the building. All right, got everything all set up for the ceremony and reception. We're all set to go. I'm using the Bose S1 Pro with my iPad Pro running DJ software and a Sennheiser G4 wireless mic. Tested everything out, it all looks good, sounds good. I gotta get rid of my bags. Ceremony, pretty simple. I've got 3 songs total, preceding music, and a reader, that's it. I'll try to get some footage of that. All right, stick around. Holy shit. I had to come outside to tell the story. I'm right starting ceremony. And by the way, I turn on my Bose S1 Pro, flashes 4 blues, which means it's fully charged, right? Sitting there and waiting, talking with the photographer. Okay, here we go, game on, right? Wedding party comes in. I happen to look at the Bose S1. It's flashing the red light, like the battery's about to die. And it's not just like blinking, it's like the you're fucked, you're fucked, you're fucked. I literally, they're zooming it, right? And I'm on one side of the, you see the video, I'm on one side. So I have to walk across, just, you know, real casual. Like, I'm just kind of like walking across, like, nothing, it's all good, it's all good. Out the door. I run back to my main setup and I grab one of my power cables connected to my main speaker. And again, I'm running back. It's like that scene in Ferris Bueller. Luckily, I had my setup close to a wall outlet because I was plugging my wireless mic inside. Oh my god, that's never happened, Bose. Why did that happen? I didn't charge it last night, but I checked it last night. I turned it on and I got 4 blues. And I'm like, I'm good. It should get 6-8 hours, not 30 fucking minutes. It's all good. I just talked to the bride. She's like, you were amazing. The music was awesome. I was like, oh, yeah, really? Good.
Yeah.
All right, it is the next morning. It's Sunday morning, and I just wanted to recap a little bit about what we watched. Stick around to the end. I promise you, I'll show you my tits. I got to kick out my first Wedding Crashers. The way that the venue was set up, we had a garage door that opened up, and it was downtown Minneapolis, so we had some buildings and an alleyway in between where the venue was. And as I was playing music, just people were walking up and down, and four guys just sort of like wandered in and just started dancing. They were being cool. It's not like they were hitting up the bar or grabbing bridesmaids' asses or anything like that. They were just dancing, but some of the wedding party and parents were looking at me like, get these guys the fuck out of here. I just walked up to them and I was like, hey guys, glad you're enjoying the tunes. However, this is a private party and you gotta bounce. And they were like, oh, okay, cool, no problem, no problem. And you know, they left. Very briefly, I wanna mention that my RCF JMix8s were awesome. Oh my God. I'm very impressed with them. I'm gonna do a full video reviewing them and I'll tell you my thoughts on why I got them and am I still gonna use the EV30Ms? And briefly, I'll say yes for smaller events, but the JMix8s were, they were pretty banging. So I was excited about that. Last thing I wanna mention is something happened last night that I just wanted to share with you. The groom's mom was not able to make it because of health reasons. It just happened suddenly, right? He actually emailed me that morning, hey, just so you know, my mom's not gonna be able to make it, so we won't be able to do the mother-son dance. Something hit me, especially during speeches. They were talking about her and how missed she was. So I decided, you know what, instead of just crossing it off the list, let's make a moment here. So I had the groom step onto the dance floor with his wife, and I said, hey everyone, normally this is the part of the night where the groom dances with his mom, but as you all know, Mary can't make it tonight. So here's what I'm gonna ask. I'm gonna have Kevin dance with his wife, and I want all of you out there, come on out on the dance floor and let's do that song all together and show your love and support for him. And it was really, really cool. Everybody came out onto the dance floor. The groom got really emotional and it was like this just great moment that we could have together as the group. And then I launched right into the dance right after that. All right, everyone, thanks for watching. If you like this and you like me, then you know what to do and just do that shit.